Welcome back to another episode in the GDScript Fundamental Tutorial Series. In this episode, we'll be talking about the for loop. So what exactly is a for loop? A for loop is a control flow statement which allows code to be executed repeatedly. Godot uses iterator-based for loops. What this means is that this type of for loop allows for the enumeration of sets of items other than number sequences. In Godot, a for loop is used when you want to iterate through a range, such as numbers, arrays, or even tables. When looping through an array, the current element is stored in the loop variable. When iterating through a dictionary, the index is stored in the loop variable. In Godot, this is what a basic for loop will look like. You have the keyword for, followed by a name for the placeholder, followed by the word in, followed by a range. A range can be anything from an integer to an array to even a dictionary. No matter what, the range is what determines how many times we're going to run the code inside the block statement. This is what a for loop looks like with a number. As you can see here, we have a 4, x, and 10, 10 being the range. What this means is that our block statement is going to execute 10 times. Keep in mind that when using numbers, the variable in the for loop, in this case x, will start at 0 and increment until the variable is greater than or equal to the number used as the range. This is what a for loop will look like with an array. So basically, I hope you're seeing a pattern here, and that's the range is what determines how many times we're going to run our block statement. So in this case, our value x, which can be used in the block statement, will be executed for as many items as there are in the array. And lastly, you can also pass dictionaries into your for loops. And lastly, you can use dictionaries inside a for loop. Keep in mind that when using a dictionary, the value of x will basically be all the keys in your dictionary. So this is what a basic for loop flowchart would look like. As you can see, we're entering through our code, and now we've entered our for loop condition. In Godot, the condition of our for loop is basically as long as we have not reached the end of our range. And as long as we haven't reached the end of our range, we enter the statement block, we execute all the code in the statement block, we update the counter, and then we check the condition of our for loop. This keeps going until the condition of our for loop is false. Again, the condition being as long as we haven't reached the end of our range. As long as we reach the end of our range, we exit the loop. Let's go ahead and take a look at some coding examples. So let's go ahead and take a look at this coding example right here. I went ahead and I created three variables, basically from our examples in the slideshow earlier. I have created a variable for numbers, a variable for an array, and a variable for a dictionary. So let's go ahead and take a look at this example here. So I went ahead and zoomed in so you have an easier time seeing. As you can see here, I have a for loop. In this first example, we'll be looping over an integer. In this case, our value will start at 0. And will execute 10 times, and 10 times it will execute the code in our statement block, which is to print out the value. Basically, we're going to print out all the numbers from 0 through 9. In the next example, we'll be looping through an array. As you can see here, we have a local variable called element, and it will be passed an element starting from the index position 0 of our array, and it will iterate until we reach the end of our array. In this case, we're going to print out the values. Lastly, we have a for loop, which is taking in a dictionary object. Keep in mind that for this for loop, the local variable, in this case key, will be passed the key values of the dictionary object, in this case the indexes. So when we go ahead and print out the key, we'll be printing out the key. However, if you would like to print out the value associated to the key, if you would like to print out the value associated to that key, you'll go ahead and type the standard dictionary brackets key to return the value for that key. Well, that's basically it. For loops are pretty simple. Thank you for watching this episode. I look forward to seeing you in the next.